So I rise to support the Indian Forest Amendment Bill 2017. It is a simple bill. It would put an end to the need for getting a permission to transport bamboo. The bill would do away with the interstate permit for transportation of bamboo. Under the Act, the definition of tree includes palms, bamboo, stumps, brushwood and a cane. So the government has brought this bill to amend its definition to remove the word bamboo. It is proposed to waive the requirement of permission for clearing or transportation for economic use of bamboo grown in a non-forest area. I am sure this amendment will encourage farmers and other individuals to take up a bamboo cultivation under agro-forest mission. This step will go a long way in enhancing the agricultural income of farmers and tribals, especially in the northeast, central India and some to the extent of the tribal areas of Andhra Pradesh. India has the largest area under bamboo cultivation and is the second richest in terms of bamboo genetic resources after China. Sir, this amendment of the bill is actually in line with the above objective of doubling the income of farmers besides conservation and sustainable development. So before this amendment, the fueling and the transit of bamboo grown on a forest as well as non-forest land attracted the provisions of the Indian Forest Act 1927, IFA 1927. At the time, the government convinced that the amendment and the resultant change in the classification of bamboo grown in the non-forest area will usher in a much needed and a far-reaching reforms in the bamboo sector. Sir, some of the other benefits of amendment include enhancing supply of a raw material to the traditional craftsmen of rural India, bamboo based paper and pulp industries, cottage industries, furniture making units, fabric making units, incense stick making units, etc. Apart from promoting the major bamboo applications such as the wood substitutes and composites like panels, flooring, furniture and a bamboo blind. It will also help industries dealing with food products, bamboo shoots, construction, housing, etc. So the amendment bill will greatly help in the success of a recently constituted national bamboo mission. We are currently importing timber and allied products such as pulp, paper and furniture, etc. So this will save valuable foreign exchange. So before concluding my speech, I wanted to give one small address to our Honorable Minister, sir. So all of us, we have to think about the pollution. Even every day we are seeing in the newspapers, especially in Delhi, in other metros, the pollution. So it's the responsibility of all our public representatives and the governments. We have to make it mandatory of the tree plantation at least once in a month in every way, especially in the urban areas. And especially in our Honorable, Chief Minister, every second Saturday, we are spending for a tree plantation, sir. So throughout the country, it is very much necessary to control the pollution and to maintain the eco balance. That's why I request the Honorable Minister, so please focus on the tree plantation, sir. It's not connected to the bill also, but I'm giving advice. So with these few words, I reiterate my support to the bill. Thank you, Deputy Speaker, sir, for giving this opportunity.